friends, good morning. Myself Dr. Jyoti Shirogar, I welcome you all in my YouTube channel, which is for engineering chemistry. Now our today's topic of discussion is different sources, effects and control measures of greenhouse gases. As we know that the greenhouse effect is due to increase in temperature, so which gases are responsible for it and what are the different sources of these gases? So, number one, carbon dioxide is a very prominent gas which is responsible for greenhouse effect. It is also called as a greenhouse gas, particularly carbon dioxide. Then methane, which is one of the hydrocarbon, like that another hydrocarbons are also responsible, but prominent is methane. Then water vapor, then chlorofluorocarbon, these are the main four gases which are responsible for increasing temperature of earth day by day. So we will see today the different sources of carbon dioxide. Particularly, carbon dioxide may have the two types of sources, like natural sources and different type of man-made sources. Under the natural sources, volcanic eruption, forest fires, these points comes. So during volcanic eruption or forest fires, there is a maximum amount of carbon dioxide is released into the atmosphere. But like that, man-made sources are also more, these are not less. So in that, in the man-made sources, there is a deforestation, that is cutting of trees or cutting of plants going on for the different purposes or for the luxurious life. Such type of things are done by the human being. Then industrialization. In industrialization, we know that lot of gas or a lot of smoke, which is including different type of gases with water vapor, with carbon dioxide, different type of methane gas maybe, there is a release into the atmosphere which ultimately helps to increase the temperature. Then urbanization. For urbanization, number of trees are cut into the cut to get a more space or land. Automobile exhaust. Lot of automobiles are there due to which carbon monoxide is released into the atmosphere and ultimately there is a formation of carbon dioxide. So like that, again the population explosion, it is also one of the point. It is because during exhalation animals releases the carbon dioxide, so where there is a more number of animals or the human beings, there is a maximum carbon dioxide into the atmosphere. So these are all the sources which are to be prohibited. They are there in the which is for the increasing greenhouse effect. Then next is a methane. So we are generally not familiar with this particular methane, but we should know that from the coal mines there is a maximum exhaust of methane is there. Then decomposition of organic matter in swamps. In swamps type of areas, there is a maximum organic matter is there which get decomposed, and from that the methane type of gas is released. Then rice or paddy cultivation. So paddy cultivation or rice is a major source of release of the methane. Then guts of termites. In a guts of termites, in a forest debris, there is a release of this particular methane gas. Then stomach of ruminants. Those animals which are ruminants, they in their stomach there is a stored methane is found. Then with that, not only this methane and carbon dioxide, there is a CFC which is also called as a chlorofluorocarbon. So chlorofluorocarbon is one of the very major source for the particularly for the ozone depletion. So with that also, for increase in temperature, it is also helpful on the surface, or we can say that in the atmosphere. So the different sources of CFC is the sprays, then DOs, which are generally used in a maximum amount. So these are the sources. Then thermocalls, then there is a propellants in aerosols. From the aerosols, where there is a propellants or liquid type are used, for example, those which are the aerosols, means we can say that there is a for example the helicopters, in that fan of helicopter there is a particular liquid which is used, and whenever it's in used at that time there is a release of CFC or chlorofluorocarbon. Then after that, in the air conditioners of automobiles, in the household air conditioners, then particularly in the refrigerators which is used in house. So in this way, these are the all sources of chlorofluorocarbon. So chlorofluorocarbon due to the ozone depletion, that point when that point was arises, during that there was a ban in the different European countries on this chlorofluorocarbon or release of use of chlorofluorocarbon. So during that it it was what can we say, it was replaced by the hydrofluorocarbon during that time. And it has also, it had also been found that those level of these ozone got increased during that time whenever the banned carbon, that chlorofluorocarbon is there. So in this way, this is one of the more or major source of greenhouse effect. Now after that, the last one is a water vapor. Now in this case, whenever there is an increase in temperature by these all gases, we know that whenever there is a forest fire, maximum amount of carbon dioxide is removed, means that whenever there is a burning of organic matter, during that maximum amount of carbon dioxide released, but at the same time maximum amount of water vapor is also released into the atmosphere, which is harmful for increasing temperature. Then by increasing temperature, there is a more and more evaporation of the oceans. So during that, again more and more water vapor is present in the atmosphere or environment. So in this way, they are interdependent on each other. So these are four important sources of greenhouse effect, that is carbon dioxide, chlorofluorocarbon, methane and water vapor. Now we will see what happens whenever there is a greenhouse effect is increased or there is found the global warming. So we can simply imagine that by increasing level of carbon dioxide in I just want to share one thing, that carbon dioxide in the last two centuries, it is found by a global research that 25% of carbon dioxide only is increased into the, only carbon dioxide is increased, means its level is increased into the atmosphere, which by which there is a temperature of 0.5 degrees Celsius, global temperature has been increased. So it can be increased a lot, maybe 4 to 5 degrees in 50 to 100 next years if proper control measures are not taken. So we have to control all the these particular gases or sources. Then urbanization, so these are the all sources and due to which there is an increase. So by increasing temperature, again what are the possible things or how it gets dangerous, it becomes dangerous for us, in that whenever there is an increasing temperature, fertility of soil gets decreases. How? Because it is because by increasing temperature, the soil gets dried, or the maximum water present in the soil, in the ocean, in the river gets evaporated. So it becomes dried, and those nutrients which are present in the soil, they cannot get proper volume of water to move from one place to another place to get by that particular plant. So in this way, the water, due to decreasing water level, there is a decrease in fertility of soil, which is a very much or we can say that a major effect. Then by increasing temperature, again there is a different skin diseases arise. Then plants get damaged, different type of diseases are there for the plants due to increasing temperature. When directly the sun rays fall on the that plants, it gets damaged because it doesn't require such a large temperature. So then oceans, they gets evaporated in a large extent, then the which is also dangerous. Then after that, one point which remains is that polar ice caps which are found on the different poles of the earth, that can be melted. So when that will be molten, the maximum flood may form. So which is also one of the dangerous thing for the life on the earth. So due to this global warming or due to this greenhouse effect, there is a maximum problem would have been faced for the human being particularly. Then the important thing which is to be studied is the control measures of greenhouse effect. Now, how can we control it then? So here, for point of source is a deforestation. So we should not carry out a deforestation. We should not cut the plants. Then we should have a check on the different this forest administration, or we can say that the forest management. Then there should be minimum industrialization, and those gases which are produced from the industries, those more hazardous gases are there, that should be re-cleaned and then removed into the atmosphere. There should be less urbanization for which the plants are required, that should be not cut. Then there should be minimum amount, or we can say that minimum use of automobile, where there is a fuels are also there, and due to increase in fossil fuels, due to one point which is there, that burning of fossil fuel, it is also important thing for the removal of carbon dioxide. So fossil fuel should not be burned more, so which is again comes under the fuels, or whenever the use of fuel is there. Then population explosion, it is totally in our hand that it should not be increased. Then from the coal mines, so it is again related to the fuel. Then decomposition of organic matter, the proper yearly check on these all things should be there. In this way, then when we see the chlorofluorocarbon, in this case, the minimum, there should be minimum use of chlorofluorocarbon, that is the minimum use of household refrigerators, then DOs, sprays, then propellant in aerosols. So all this should be minimized. Then only it is possible to decrease the level of carbon dioxide. Otherwise, it would have been very impossible for us. So we have to do the check. As we are educated, we have to do the different control measures on it. So in this way, today we have seen this particular different sources, effects and control measures of greenhouse effect. So we are only responsible for this as we understood this thing. So we, by our level, we can do this thing. So we should do it. Okay, thank you very much.